And for that reason, I'm going to begin from number one. Quality purchasing points of eggs. Number one, I've said the shell. The shell should be clean, undamaged, and slightly rough. Clean, undamaged, and slightly rough. Then the white. The egg white should have a bigger proportion of the thick white than the thin white. Then now number three, the yolk. Yolk is the yellow part of the egg. Around. The yolk should be firm. Ukisema firm, tunamaanisha nini? Ukipasua mayai ukiweka hiyo yellow part inafaa ingie ikikaa kama ball ikiwa round isikuwa imetokana tokana. So the yolk should be firm and rounded in shape. So it's round, firm and rounded in shape with a good yellow color. With a good yellow color. That is the yolk. The last quality purchasing points of eggs, number four. The smell. How does an egg smell? The smell of an egg. Now, the smell of a quality egg should be pleasant. Now, when we say pleasant, this is what we mean. It should not smell rotten. It should not have the smell of ammonia. The smell of ammonia or the smell of hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide smells like rotten eggs. So your egg should not have any other funny smell than the smell of eggs. So the smell of a good quality egg should be pleasant. That is all about the quality purchasing points of eggs. The other aspects I want to talk about is the storage of eggs. How do we store eggs? The storage of eggs. Point number one in storing eggs, one, they must be stored in a cool, dry place. They should be stored in a cool, dry place. So if you are not refrigerating your eggs, because eggs can be refrigerated, if you are not refrigerating, then if you are not refrigerating, then you are supposed to keep them in a cool place. The other point, number two, if refrigerated, ukiamua mayai yako unaweka kwa fridge, una store kwa fridge. If refrigerated, store at temperatures. If refrigerated, store at temperatures of 0 to 3 degrees. Store at temperatures of 0 to 3 degrees, because we've already said that they should be stored in a cool place. So 0 to 3 degrees. The other point, number three, when storing eggs, store away from strong smelling foods, e.g. cheese, onions, and fish. When you are storing eggs, store away from strong smelling foods such as fish, onions, and cheese. Now, the eggshell is usually porous. When it is porous, it means it can absorb one, moisture from outside, and two, smell from outside. So, because of that, the porous nature of the eggshell, when you keep them near strong smelling foods, that smell will be absorbed into the egg. Then you will wonder why you cook the egg and it has some other funny smells and the egg is not rotten. It is because of absorbing smells from other foods when you store them, when you do not store them appropriately. Those are the three points on the storage of eggs. Now, let's go to uses of eggs. Uses of eggs. Use number one. Enrich. Enrich. E-N-R-I-C-H. Enrich. What is to enrich? To enrich is to make rich. And in this case, eggs make, they add the richness of foods, flavor, and texture. So when we say enrich, we say eggs are used to improve the texture and flavor of certain products. So zile products unaweka mayai kama cakes, kama pancake, anything kama mandazi, anything that you are putting eggs inside. You are putting them, and those eggs will enrich. They will give more flavor and more texture. They will also improve the nutritive value because we know that eggs are proteins. Another use, number two. They are used to give color. They are used to give color. They are used to give color. When we say to give color, we mean they make our products turn brown. When we are baking, for example, when we are baking bread rolls, we egg wash, tunapaka mayai hapo juu. So they can come out when they are having a nice brown color. So they give color. So about giving color, you can write this. Eggs are used to give color to some foods, especially baked products. Use of egg number three. The use of egg number three. Binding. Binding. To bind is to kushikanisha, to bring together, to hold together. Binding. Binding. You've seen us in the kitchen making croquette potatoes or making bread-crumbed fish fillet. When we are making bread-crumbed fish fillet, what do? We take the fillet, we pass it through flour, then tunaweka kwa mayai, and then we pass through breadcrumbs and then deep fry. So whatever holds those breadcrumbs, hapo kwa nyama zisitoke, ni hiyo mayai. That's why we dip in egg, then the breadcrumbs. So the egg helps to bind together the breadcrumbs and the meat. So that is binding. So eggs act as a binding agents to various products, e.g. breadcrumbed fish fillet. Another use of eggs, aerating. To aerate is to act as a raising agent, to put more air, more oxygen. Aerating. Then we write this. When beaten, tukipiga mayai. When beaten, eggs entrap tiny bubbles of air. When beaten, eggs entrap tiny bubbles of air. That's why unaonaga ukipiga mayai, ukiwhisk mayai, inakuwa na bubbles. It doubles in size. Unaona pofu inajaa kwa bakuli. Inakuwa ina trap air particles. So tiny bubbles of air. And this is a property in eggs. And this is a property in eggs. So that is to say that eggs are used as, unaweka into bracket, they are used as raising agents. They are used as raising agents. They are used as raising agents. So that is another use of eggs. Next, garnishing. Another use of eggs, garnishing. Eggs can be used to garnish. So garnishing. Then under garnishing, we write this. Eggs can add color. Eggs can add color to a variety of dishes. Eggs can add color to a variety of dishes, especially appetizers. Eggs can give color to a variety of dishes, especially appetizers. Now, I know that your menus don't usually include an appetizer. Your menus begin with the main meal, then the dessert. But when you start doing the CFB, once you're done with artisan and you join CFB, you'll realize that we have a starter, which is an appetizer. Then now we go to the main meal and then the dessert. So appetizers, mostly the egg is used to garnish if the appetizer is a salad, not a soup. For example, when you have salmon, something like salmon mayonnaise, you can garnish with a boiled egg. you cut the rings of boiled egg. So it becomes a garnish because of the nice white and yellow. Kisha boil mayai. So that is all about garnishing. The other use of eggs, they are used as a main meal. They are used as a main meal. Main meal means what? An egg is a protein. You've seen us making scorched egg, jikoni, kama protein. You've seen us making egg curry in the kitchen, kama protein. We can also have boiled eggs, kama protein. We can have fried egg as a protein. We can have scrambled egg, or we can also have omelets. So when we say as a main meal, tunamaanisha the food that you are serving. If you are having, you have the egg curry, braised rice, steamed cabbage. Hiyo chakula unaserve. The main protein there is the egg. So the egg is used as a main meal. So those are the uses of eggs that I am going to give you for today. But when you look at your handout, you will see more additional uses of eggs. Now, the last bit I'll talk about on eggs is the methods of cooking eggs. The methods of cooking eggs. There are many methods in which we can cook our eggs. So, which methods am I going to talk about today? Number one is poaching. 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 Poaching is a wet method of cooking. So I'm going to define what poaching is. Eggs are cooked. Eggs are cooked in the required amount of liquid. Eggs are cooked in the required amount of liquid, just below boiling point. Eggs are cooked in the required amount of liquid, just below boiling point. So poaching is not boiling, but it is almost like boiling. In this case, the liquid is simmering. When it is boiling, the liquid is vigorously boiling. We say that simmering is cooking just below the boiling point. Another method we can cook eggs, number two, boiling. We can boil our eggs. Method number three, frying. We can have fried eggs. And fry, we have frying in two types. We have shallow frying and we have deep frying. Shallow frying is when we do not immerse the food in cooking oil. Deep frying is when we put the food in a lot of cooking oil. Now, when we are making omelet, we are making fried egg, or we are making Spanish omelet, we use shallow frying. When we are making scorched eggs, we use two methods here. Tuna boil, mayai inakuwa ngumu. We take them out, we remove the shell, we cover with the sausage meat. After that, tuna deep fry. So we can deep fry and we can also shallow fry our eggs. Those are the three methods in which we can make our eggs. So I am done with the part of eggs as dairy products. So do we have questions about eggs before I go to milk? Maswali niulizo, maswali nimewa unmute. You can unmute your mic now and talk. Maswali ya eggs. Valerie, any question about eggs? Evelyn, any question about eggs? Maswali. Evelyn. Question? Evelyn, question about eggs. Sikusikii, nakuona unaongea but sikusikii. Ninangoja maswali ya eggs. Maswali ya eggs. Margaret. Swali. Margaret, any question about eggs? Although nimeona umeingia class late. Faith, any question? Christine, swali. Akinyi. Maswali ndio nangoja. Sawa, Teresia, no question. So, can I proceed to milk? Can I proceed to milk? Niambiwe kama naweza endelea kwa milk. You can type in hapa chini kwa chat. Okay. Sawa, sawa. So on milk, I want you to, like I've said with the eggs, I have said that you have the handout, but I still want you to write your short notes on the specific areas that I am mentioning. So for instance, I have said, we've talked about eggs. I've said you write the quality purchasing points of eggs, which were four. The other one we've talked about uses of eggs, nikasema uziandike. We've also talked about storage of eggs. I've given you three of them. I've said you write them down. And I have said you still go back to your handout. These notes, these short notes that I am giving you are to guide you in revising. So that when you look at that handout, when you're reading the handout, you know exactly where to read. For example, if it is about quality purchasing points, you go to the handout, check all the quality purchasing points that are there. The storage of eggs, nimekupatia tatu, go to your handout, check out whether there are more, uongeze. Then if you are having the uses of eggs, I have given you, I think, about five or six. They are very many, they are more than 10. Enda pale kwa handout, ongezea. You know that is an important section or segment of that handout. The cooking methods that I have given you, go to your handout, check whether there are more. Now, about milk. There are specific things that I want you to write about milk. Now, the first one, we are going to define what milk is. And the reason why we are defining milk is because for you, you did a topic known as nutrition. Kuna topic tulifanya inaitwa nutrition. And nutrition is simply about foods and about the value of those foods, what those foods give our body of nutritive value. So let's define milk. Milk is a white, nutritious food. Milk is a white, nutritious food, particularly for young children. Particularly for young children. Full stop. That is the definition of milk. A white, nutritious food, particularly for young children. So everybody knows that young children take milk. They are breastfed, they also take milk. So milk acts as their food. Let's write something else about milk. In catering, milk is used in a variety of dishes. In catering, milk is used in a variety of dishes, both hot and cold. In catering, milk is used in a variety of dishes, both hot and cold. So when we are using milk in the kitchen, we use it in very many ways. Sometimes we add to our mashed potatoes when we are mashing potatoes. Some other times, we also boil milk for coffee. We cook tea with milk. So milk has got many, many uses. Sometimes we add onto our cake when we want to increase the consistency or to correct the consistency of that cake. So milk has got a variety of uses. Now, the other important part, types of milk. I want you to list them down. Types of milk. The handout that I send you, when you look at what is written under milk, it has got many segments, but I want to you to write this down so that when you are reading the handout, you are able to identify the particular types of milk that you are supposed to be looking out for. So write this about types of milk. Number one, pasteurized milk. Yes, Faith, that definition is very correct. That definition is also very correct. So, pasteurized milk, that is our first type of milk. Pasteurized milk. Pasteurize is to simply treat on very high temperature or to heat using high temperatures. So, pasteurized milk, let's define it. This is milk heated to a temperature of 71.7 degrees. Milk heated to a temperature of 71.7 degrees for 15 seconds. Milk heated to a temperature of 71.7 degrees for 15 seconds to kill any pathogenic bacteria for 15 seconds to kill any pathogenic bacteria and then rapidly cooled and then rapidly cooled to a temperature below 10 degrees, and then rapidly cooled to a temperature below 10 degrees. That is pasteurized milk. That is the first type of milk. Type number two, homogenized. Homogenized milk. Homogenized milk. Now, if you've ever boiled milk, kama umewahi nunua maziwa ukaboil, fresh milk, ukiboil maziwa na uweke mahali poe, when you come back to the cooled milk, unapataga imejiseparate. It has the top part, yenye tunaitaga cream, yenye unaweza toa, and it has the other part now, yenye imebaki the liquid milk, the white part. The cream is usually almost turns yellowish. The reason is because that is the fat. Hiyo ndio mafuta ya maziwa. Now, when we talk of homogenized milk, this is milk which has been treated to a high level of heat such that it does not separate. Haijitoi ikabaki na cream na liquid inashikana, haiwezi achana. That is homogenized milk. Now, write this about it. This is milk that has been processed. Milk that has been processed such that the cream does not separate to form a layer on top of the milk. This is milk that has been processed such that the cream does not separate to form a top layer or to form a layer on top of the milk. That is all about homogenized milk. Number three, sterilized milk. Sterilized milk. Now, sterilized milk has got another name. It is also known as ultra heat treated. Ultra heat treated milk. Ama UHT. Ile maziwa tunaita UHT. Ultra heat treated. And it is also known as long life milk. It's also known as long life milk. That is our milk number three. Sterilized stroke, ultra heat treated stroke, long life. Now let's write something about it. This is homogenized milk. Okay, okay, Teresia. So I'm in milk number three. Sterilized stroke, ultra heat treated stroke, long life. So maziwa yenye tunaita long life ndio inaitwa sterilized milk na pia inaitwa UHT, ultra heat treated. So let's define what that is all about. This is homogenized milk treated to a high temperature. This is homogenized milk treated to a high temperature for a very short period of time. For a very short period of time to produce a sterile product. To produce a sterile product that will keep for up to 6 months. That will keep for up to 6 months. So, kukua sterile. When something is sterile, it means it is non-reactive. Yes, it reacts to anything. No bacteria can survive in it for a period of whole 6 months. That's why ile maziwa long life yenye inauzwa kwa shop ama kwa supermarket and it is written long life. It can stay for 6 months. When you look at it, utaona if it was manufactured in, let's say, March, you see the expiry date. Imeandikwa kitu kama October. So mpaka 6 months ziishe. Milk number four, skimmed milk. Milk number four, skimmed milk. Kuskim ni kutoa top layer. Kuskim ni kutoa top layer. So hii inamaanisha, iyo maziwa yako ulitoa ile cream ya juu, uliseparate. Ukatoa cream ya juu, ile liquid peke yake nduka, uka process, ika form skimmed milk. Na ukitoa top layer inamaanisha umetoa mafuta. So skimmed milk is milk which is usually low in fat. So let's write this about skimmed milk. This is milk with only a small percentage of fat. Milk with only a small percentage of fat, but high content in minerals and proteins. It is milk with only a small percentage of fat, but high content of minerals and proteins. Nataka uweke into brackets, 0 to 1% fat. Into brackets, 0 to 1% fat. So the content of fat in skimmed milk is 0 to 1%, kwa sababu ile cream ilitolewa. Milk number five, buttermilk. Buttermilk, B-U-T-T, buttermilk, that is another type of milk, buttermilk, and let's write this about buttermilk. This is a byproduct. It is a byproduct. In other words, buttermilk is produced when you are using milk to make butter. Unajua butter, mafuta yenye inaitwa butter. So buttermilk is a byproduct of butter making. So when we are making butter from milk, we also get buttermilk. It is a product byproduct of butter making, which contains much of the minerals and proteins, which contains much of the minerals and proteins contained in whole milk. It contains much of the minerals and proteins contained in whole milk. Milk number 6, condensed milk. Condensed milk. That is our milk number 6, condensed milk. Now, after condensed milk, I talk about another type of milk which is similar to this. So let me explain what this is and explain the other one. You must confuse. Now, condensed milk is milk which has been removed some moisture. Imetolewa maji. Lakini si powder milk. Imetolewa some of the moisture na ikawekwa sukari during processing. So, condensed milk iko na ile thickness ya yogurt. Haitakaa watery kama fresh milk. Iko na consistency kama ya yogurt, lakini iko na sukari na haina any other flavor. It is just milk, thick milk, and it is sugary. That is what we call condensed milk. So let's write this about it. This is milk in which a large proportion of water. This is milk in which a large proportion of water is removed and sugar is added during processing. Large proportion of water is removed and sugar is added during processing. Now, this takes me to my next type, number 7. Evaporated milk. Evaporated milk. We all know what is evaporate is. Unaweka kwa moto and then unaacha steam inaenda. When the steam goes, that evaporation, the liquid part pia inaendelea kwenda. So let's write this about evaporated milk. And that's why I have said it is similar to condensed milk. They only have one difference. Condensed milk, tumesema, umetoa maji, umeweka sukari. With evaporated, utatoa maji, lakini haina sukari. That is the only difference between condensed milk and evaporated milk. So let's write this. This is similar to condensed milk. This is similar to condensed milk. Without addition of sugar, evaporated milk, it is similar to condensed milk. Without addition of sugar and has more water content. So iko na two differences, condensed milk na evaporated milk. Condensed milk iko na sukari, evaporated milk haina sukari. Condensed milk iko more thicker than evaporated milk. So kwa condensed milk you've removed more moisture, evaporated milk umetoa moisture kidogo. On to my last type of milk, dried milk. Hii inaitwa powdered milk. Dried milk. Hii inaitwa powdered milk. Hii ni ile maziwa ya tunaitaga milk powder. Sold in the supermarket. Milk powder. Hiyo ni maziwa yenye imekaushwa. If you watch YouTube videos, you will see how it is made. They'll simply evaporate the milk until it becomes thick. Then they dry it. And then break it into small pieces and blend. Inakuwa to flakes, then they blend. Inakuwa unga. So that is powdered milk, what we call dried milk. So we write this. It is prepared from skimmed milk. Tushasoma skimmed milk. It was our number 4. Tukasema umetoa cream. So when we are making milk powder, tunatumiaga iyo maziwa yenye tulitoa cream. Isikuwe too fatty, isikuwe na too a lot of fat content. So it is prepared from skimmed milk. From which? Prepared from skimmed milk. From which? Most of the water and fat content has been removed. Is prepared from skimmed milk, from which most of the water and fat content has been removed. It is then dried to a fine powder. It is then dried to a fine powder. Now, those are the 8 types of milk that I wanted to talk about. Now, I want to give you this assignment, which will tell me the answers next week. I want you to go and look at your handout, Google, look for research about this. I want you next week to tell me what is soya milk. And what are the uses? What is soya milk and its uses? Number two, tell me what is coconut milk and the uses. So it's ombili about milk. Soya milk na coconut milk. Tell me what they are and how they are used. Soya milk, coconut milk. What they are, how they are used. Next, uses of milk. Uses of milk. Now, here I want to unmute you people to tell me how we use milk. No, I've actually not muted you people. So unmute your mic and tell me the uses of milk. Acha nianze na Valerie. Valerie, tell me one use of milk.
It is used for cooking.
Cooking what? Cooking what? Cooking tea, yes. Margaret?
Used for baking.
Used for?
Baking.
For?
When baking.
Yes, it is used in baking. Sour. Faith, another use of milk.
Is used to oh my
is used to apart from cooking tea, baking, another use
maintain strong bone
to bind. No, we don't use milk to bind. Angela, give me a use of milk.
It's used as a beverage.
Sour, it is used as a beverage, yes. Another person. Emma, give me a use of milk. Emma, a use of milk. Yes, making ice cream. Sour, Teresia, it's used in making ice cream. Evelyn, Mugo. Evelyn, give me a use of milk.
Using cooking vegetables.
Sour cooking vegetables. I don't want to tell me the traditional vegetables. It is okay. It is used in cooking vegetables. Akinyi, a use of milk. Akinyi.
Yes.
A use of milk.
I've said it
yes.
already. All that's not the answer.
Oh, they've already been saying all the answers.
I've said it can be also used to in cooking vegetables.
Yes, our cooking vegetables. Now, Omolo Faith.
Yes.
Diuretic. Do you mean it is used for invalids? What is diuretic?
It's like a substance that promotes that promotes diuresis.
Mm-hmm. So now, in other words, you are trying to say that milk is used especially as food for the sick people. People who are not able to consume solid foods. Yes, to make yogurt, that is correct. So let's write these uses. Write these uses of milk. Number one, it is used to improve. It is used to improve the texture and flavor of soups. Wakati tunapika soup, we put milk to tunaongeza hiyo flavor na texture. So improves the flavor and texture of soups. Number two, used in hot and cold beverages. Used in hot and cold beverages. So kwa chai, tea, kwa coffee, to take it as a beverage, whether hot or cold. So used in hot and cold beverages. Number three, used in preparation of sauces. Kwa mfano, when you are having vanilla cake pale jikoni na tunataka kuitengenezea sauce, tunaitengenezea custard sauce. Hapo kwa custard sauce, kwa custard powder, tunaonaga tukikoroga na maziwa. Ama we want to make, tuko na chocolate cake, we want to make chocolate sauce. You also see us tukiweka maziwa. So those are the sauces we are talking about. So making sauces. So tunaweza weka example, e.g. chocolate sauce, custard sauce, bread sauce, ile ya kuku, bread sauce. Jason, okay. Next, it is used in baked products. Used in baked products. E.g. cakes. Baked products, e.g. cakes. So sometimes when we've used our eggs and the consistency, the cake is still too thick. You see us adding milk little by little. Then also there are those cakes that are eggless. Zile cake zenye hazina mayai. For example, you're cooking a cake for people who don't take eggs. So in place of eggs, you put what? Milk. Another use. It is used as a base for ice creams. When we say base, any ingredient we call a base in any item, it means as a main ingredient. So it is used as a base in making ice creams. Next one. It is used in main meals. It is used in main meals, especially for invalids. It is used in main meals, especially for invalids. I have said that invalids are sick people. People who cannot eat solid foods. They are recuperating or recovering from hospital. They've been feeding through pipes and now they just want to start feeding on their own. Their system cannot yet take the whole food that we take, so they take milk. So used in main meals, especially for invalids. And remember, we also defined it as food for children. The last point about the use of milk, it is used in the preparation of frying butters. Preparation of frying butters. A frying butter ni mixture kama ile ya pancake. Ukitaka kupika pancake, unachukua unga, maziwa, sukari, some little salt, mayai, baking powder, una mix. Iyo mixture ya iyo unga na maziwa yenye inakaa uji uji, iyo ni butter. So we either make pancake with it. Sometimes we coat fish fillets with it. Na coat nayo fish fillet ukidip fry. in frying butter. So milk is used in making frying butters. Those are the uses. The next item, the next topic I talk about on milk or subtopic, food value of milk. Food value of milk. I said the reason why I'm teaching you food value is because you usually have a topic in your tulisha soma kitambo, term one, inaitwa nutrition. And nutrition is usually very wide. Apart from just what is covered in the topic, you can get any question concerning anything in nutrition. You can get a question on any type of food and you are asked, what is the food value or what does this particular food give us? So let's look at the food value of milk. And under this food value, we write number one. One is protein. So milk is rich in protein, or milk gives us protein. Number two, milk gives us calcium. So it has calcium. Three, iron. Milk gives us iron. So it is not only liver that gives iron, also milk gives iron. Number contains the mineral water, all those. So milk also gives you water. Next, vitamin A. So milk gives you vitamin A. Na ya mwisho, vitamin B groups. Vitamin B groups. Now, under that, nataka ujiandikie your own research question hapo. After you write vitamin B groups, so I want you to go and find out the specific vitamin B groups that you get from milk. Uziandike hapo. So when I say the specific vitamin B groups, najua kuna B12, kuna B1, kuna B2. So go and find out which specific vitamin B groups do we get from milk. Uziandike hapo kwa vitamin B groups into brackets. The other assignment I'm giving you about milk, I want you to discuss the storage of milk. Discuss the storage of milk. Hizo zote ziko kwa hiyo handout yako. Utaenda tu kwa handout, uzione, uziandike. And then next class, tukianza, tunaanza na hizo kudiscuss. Ijue kama they are the correct ones. So discuss the storage of milk. Now, this text me to milk products. So jiandikia ka subtopic milk products. When we say milk products, tunamaanisha there are things that we get from milk or we make from milk. Na nataka utofautishe types of milk and types of milk products. Types of milk tumeona there are 8. We have pasteurized milk, we have homogenized milk, we have skimmed milk, we have UHT milk, we have the condensed milk, evaporated milk, and the dried milk. Now we are going on to what do we get, which products do we make from milk? So write this under the types of milk, under the milk products. Milk products. Product number one is yogurt and fermented milk. Yogurt and fermented milk. Yogurt and fermented milk. Yogurt and fermented milk. Kila mtu anajua yogurt. The reason why we are saying yogurt and fermented milk is because they are like one and the same thing. Their only difference ni yogurt can be flavored, different flavors. Pia inaweza kuwa sweetened, inaweza ongezwa sugar. But fermented milk is like plain yogurt, no sugar, no flavor, no nothing. Yenye tunaitaga mala. So yogurt and fermented milk. Let's write these about them. Yogurt is made from homogenized milk. Yogurt is made from homogenized milk. Yogurt is made from homogenized milk. Full stop. Now, I want us to define it. This is milk, is a milk product. This is a milk product produced by, is a milk product produced by inoculating. I've written inoculating apple quotas. Produced by inoculating warm water. Inoculating warm water with a bacteria culture. Inoculating warm water with a bacteria culture. Now, when we talk about a bacteria culture is something, how do I call it? Edible. It is something edible, sisumu. Something edible, but it is acidic. It is edible, but acidic. For example, vinegar, lemon juice, isn't what you like, edible, but acidic. So we put them in warm milk. Ukishaweka hiyo kwa fresh milk, already unaonaga maziwa inaanza kukaa kama inakatika katika na ina thicken. So that is part of the process of making yogurt and fermented milk. Yogurt can be flavored. Yogurt can be flavored or plain. Yogurt can be flavored or plain. So ndio maana unaweza pata strawberry yogurt, vanilla yogurt, banana yogurt, chocolate yogurt. You can have as many flavors of yogurt as possible. So yogurt can be flavored or plain. Pia unapataje kuna plain yogurt. It is used in making curry. When you are making chicken curry, curried chicken, ama curried lamb, unapataka yogurt, natural yogurt, is an ingredient. Atata, when you are making biryani also, natural yogurt, ama mala, is an ingredient. So used in making curry, comma, used in marinating, you know what is to marinate, to season and tenderize meat. Used in marinating, not all meats, not all menus, not all recipes, that is, but is used in marinating. It is used as a salad dressing. I know, I'm so many salads, because so many people CFB. Used as a salad dressing. And it is used in preparation of fruit foods. Fruitful is a dessert. You might do fruitful, mango full, or just generally fruitful. Now, that was our milk product number one. Let's go to milk product number two. And our milk product number two is known as cheese. So write cheese. Milk product number two. Cheese. This is made from milk. This is made from milk of cows, sheep, camels, buffaloes, goats, etc. So it can come from the milk of all those animals, including what? Buffalo. Now, I want us to write a subtopic about cheese. Factors that affect the flavor of cheese. Factors that affect the flavor of cheese. Flavor ni nini? The taste. Vile ina taste, vile ina ile scent, vile ina nuka, ama ina nukia. So there are things that affect it. For example, ukionja cheese, there are some cheese which are salty, very salty. Zingine ziko plain, hazina salt yoyote. Zingine ziko too strong, too fermented. Zingine, they are just a bit fermented. What brings these differences? So those are the factors affecting the flavor of cheese. Number one, quality and type of milk used. So which milk did you use? Which quality of milk did you use? Did you use good quality or poor quality? Pia the type. Did you use skimmed milk? Did you use long life milk? Did you use homogenized milk? Which type did you use? Number two, moisture content in the cheese. Tutaangalia the cheese making process. Utaona kuna vile hiyo maziwa inatolewa completely, inabaki ikiwa haina anything. So moisture, if it has some moisture, ile itakuwa, the texture will be different, itakuwa soft. Kama haina moisture kabisa, itakuwa very hard. So moisture content. Number three, the percentage of salt added. The percentage of salt added. Nimesema kuna zenye ziko very salty, zingine hazina salt completely. So that will affect. Yenye iko salty, utasikia, utaona iliwekwa salt mingi. Yenye haina, haikuwekwa. Next, the difference in the manufacturing processes. The differences in the manufacturing processes. So it depends with how it was manufactured, how it was made. That is what will determine the flavor. Now, let's have another subtopic about cheese. I know cheese has got some subtopics because it is a process making cheese. Remember, we have milk, and from this milk, we want to get cheese. So write cheese making process. Cheese making process. Step number one when making cheese is known as clotting. What is a clot? Clotting. We talk of blood clots. When something has clotted, it means it was liquidy or watery, but now it has thickened and broken into lumps. So similar to this particular clotting I'm talking about here, we are having liquid milk, maziwa ya kawaida. And then we start by clotting that milk. Tunataka igande, hiyo maziwa igande na ikatike katike kae chunks. So that is clotting. So we write this. This is done with a bacteria starter. It is done with a bacteria starter. Ukiandika bacteria starter, put into brackets. I want to say what a bacteria starter is. Into brackets, edible acidic substance. Edible acidic substance. Edible acidic substance, e.g. lemon juice and vinegar. So lemon juice is an acidic edible substance, is a bacteria starter. Vinegar is a bacteria starter. So this is done with either a bacteria starter, into brackets, what I have said, or with RENET. RENET is an enzyme. With RENET enzyme. With RENET enzyme. So again, this enzyme makes also the milk to do what? To clot. Ikae chunks. I ferment. Ikae chunks. I ferment. Igande, that is. Step number two. That was number one, clotting. Step number two. Cutting the curd. Cutting the curd. Curd is C-U-R-D. Cutting the curd. What is curd? Curd is also known as rind. Cutting the curd. Cutting the curd. Let's define what this is. This is the removal of any rind. Rind ni skin, the outer skin. Ile maziwa tumesema number one ni kuclot. Ikisha harden, ikisha form the chunks, the outer covering, iki harden, kutoa hiyo outer hard part is what we are calling curd. So removing the curd or cutting the curd. So removing any outer rind and cutting it into pieces. Removing any outer rind and cutting it into pieces. Step number three, heating. Unaweka kwa moto. Remember, ni maziwa yako isha ferment, isha harden. Na ikiwa hivyo hivyo ime ferment na ime harden, na ime katika katika, unairudisha kwa moto ina boil. That is heating, step number three. So heating. This is done to bring the curd to boil. So vile ime katika katika hivyo ime harden, you heat it to boil. So it is done to bring the curd or the clotted milk to boil. Step number four is stirring. Kustand kukoroga. Stirring. So as much as it is fermented and you are boiling it, you also stir. So stirring. This is done to dispel the watery ways. Dispel the watery ways. I've written ways here. W-H-E-Y-S. It is done to dispel the watery ways. And what are watery ways? Remember, we've already said that I maziwa ime ferment na tunai boil. So that means kuna zile parts zime solidify and there are other watery parts. Now, the watery parts are what we are calling watery ways. So the reason we are stirring is so that we can combine them together. Tuache kukua na maziwa enye, ime divide into two parts. Ime divide into solids and liquids. You want all of it to combine and form one smooth paste. Number five, milling. Step number five is known as milling. Milling ni kusiaga. But in this case, because it is a key paste, see it tuna blend, no. We are simply tuna bonda bonda. That is milling. This is pounding. This is pounding into fine pieces. Pounding into fine pieces or particles. This is pounding into fine pieces or particles. So unaifinya finya. Inakuwa kitu kimoja. Inakuwa smooth ki paste. Paste kimoja, smooth. Number six, salting. Salting ni kuweka salt. Salting. This is for seasoning. So hapa tunaiweka, tunaipatia taste. Tunaiweka salt, we are seasoning. So salting, this is for seasoning. Step number seven, molding. Kumold ni kushape. Molding. You've seen us using cheese in the kitchen. Kuna za round, kuna za square, kuna zingine rectangular. So, those are shapes zenye zinapatikanaga in the process of molding cheese. You mold it or you shape it into whichever shape that you want it to maintain. So, molding, hyphen. This is shaping into desired shapes. This is shaping into desired shapes. Then our last step, number 8, ripening. Ripening. Ripening, kama kuifamendisha. Giving it time to ferment. It's like in the process of brewing beer. You want it to ripen up to a particular time. Ama brewing wine. Una place, unataka ifike ikuwe na a particular flavor, a particular smell, a particular taste. That is ripening. Unaiweka. So write this. This is the introduction of ripening agents. It is the introduction of ripening agents. Introduction of ripening agents. To give the cheese a characteristic flavor and smell. To give the cheese a characteristic smell and flavor. Full stop. Now, I want to unmute you. So you tell me whether you have any questions regarding the cheese making process. So you can now ask questions about the process of making cheese before we continue with any with the classification of cheese. Maswali.
I have a question.
Yes, Margaret.
Cutting the curd.
The curd, yes. Mm-hmm. About cutting the curd. Margaret?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You have a question about cutting the curd?
Cutting the curd?
Mm-hmm.
Well, so please repeat.
Sour. I said, when we talk of cutting the curd, and it is our step number 2, in eco connected na number 1. So number 1 tulisema it is doing what? Clotting the milk. Nikasema the milk is liquid. For us to clot it, it means tuyeke kitu acidic, ikatike katike, iform chunks, maziwa igande. Sawa? Maziwa ikiganda, the outer covering ita harden. The outer covering will become hard. And when it becomes hard, inakuwa ni kama cover. Ni kama cover unafaa utoe. So the cover is what we are calling the curd or the rind. And in this case, we are not supposed to remove it. Tunafaa tu tuikate kate. Ikue ndogo. So that we can now go and boil it ama heat it. So when we talk of cutting the curd, the part that has hardened, the outer covering of those milk clots, and you may harden, that is what we are calling a curd. Sawa, sawa.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
Sawa. Now, Teresia, the ripening agents that we add to cheese are molds. Molds ni fungi, ama bacteria, and they are living things. So we call them molds. They ripen the cheese. Zinafanya cheese ina ripen ama inaendelea kuferment. So we call them molds ama bacteria. Mm-hmm. Any other question regarding the cheese making process?
Last point about ripening.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. How do we put so that it can bring that smell? Where do you put it, in the fridge or somewhere? Just cool place.
No, you don't put it in the, you don't just put it anywhere. In the process of making cheese, in every stage, the way we've started, clotting, cutting the curd, stirring, milling, huku mwisho tukifika kwa ripening, you keep it in a cool, dry place where you are able to introduce the molds. Remember, together kwa fridge, molds, they are living things. They will not be able to grow. Hakuna bacteria will grow kwa cold, very cold environment, ama very hot environment. So it is a cool, dry place. And it is in a container, a container with a tight fitting lid. Any other question? Maswali zingine before I continue to the classification of cheese. Can you freeze cheese? Yes, Faith. We freeze cheese. Ikishatoka. Ikishakuwa cheese, whether mozzarella cheese, parmesan cheese, whatever type of cheese, in storage. Hizo tutaona kwa the storage of cheese. Remember, there are those cheeses and what we are supposed to grate. So, for us to be able to grate them, one, they must be very hard and frozen. No, we've seen milling is pounding, Teresia, so una bonda bonda with whatever equipment that you are having. Remember, cheese ni kikitu elastic, rubbery. So atuwezi sema tuna blend ama no. You just una bonda bonda, you pound it using a particular, either a cooking stick, a cooking spoon, whatever equipment that you are using to stir with. Now, allow me to go, if there is no other question, to go to the classification of cheese. Classification of cheese. And under classification, nataka we stroke the types of cheese. So in classification of cheese, and in classification is where we get the types of cheese. So number one, hard cheese. Hard meaning ngumu, hard cheese. Now, let me say this before we write anything or mention the rest. When we say hard cheese or soft cheese, we simply mean if it is hard, we've removed as much moisture as possible. We've removed as much moisture as possible. Ndio ikuwe ngumu. Kama ni soft, it means tumetoa moisture kidogo. So kwa ile maziwa yenye tulikuwa tunakoroga, atuja squeeze out hiyo liquid yote ikatoka, tuliacha hapo, ndio cheese ikuwe soft. Kama ni semi-soft ama semi-hard, it means we tried to remove some moisture, but not all of it, we remained some, ndio isikuwe ngumu sana. So when you find these names, hard cheese, soft cheese, semi-hard cheese, simply know it is according to the amount of moisture removed or the amount of moisture remaining in the cheese. So number one, hard cheese. This is pressed to squeeze out. This is pressed. Naifinya, you press it. It is pressed to squeeze out as much of the whey as possible. This is pressed to squeeze out as much of the whey as possible. Whey nilisema ni nini? I said that whey is that particular liquid yenye inatoka kwa maziwa. Maziwa yako ikisha ganda na unaiboil bado, kuna tumaji tunatoka ndani. That is the way I'm talking about. So if it is hard cheese, you've pressed it, you may squeeze, umetoa as much as you could have removed. Another statement about it. It requires a long ripening period. So kama unataka hard cheese, ulitoa moisture ndio, lakini pia when ripening, lazima uiache ikae for long, so that it will continue hardening. So it requires a long ripening period. And the next point about it, it is ideal for grating. It is ideal for grating. So hii ni ya grate. It is ideal for grating. Cheese number two. Semi-hard cheese. Semi-hard cheese. So semi-hard means what? It is not too hard and it is not soft. Semi-hard cheese. This is pressed sufficiently. This is pressed sufficiently to produce a firm, smooth texture. This is pressed sufficiently to produce a firm, smooth texture. That is easy to cut. That is easy to cut. That is easy to cut. Full stop. The ripening period is shorter than that of hard cheese. The ripening period is shorter than that of hard cheese. Remember, with hard cheese, tumesema, one, you squeeze out all the moisture. Then you ripen it for a long time. You delay could dry. This one is semi-hard. You just press sufficiently. Then do not let it stay too much in the ripening. You see, delay could harden. This one you can cut. With the hard one, you can only grate. Number three, soft cheese. Soft cheese. And just from the name, you know that it is soft. So it means with this one, moisture has not been removed as much. So write this about soft cheese. This is lightly pressed. It is lightly pressed to have a soft, spreadable texture. It is lightly pressed to have a soft, spreadable texture. Full stop. It sticks to a knife when cut. Ukikata ina stick kwa kisu. So it is too soft. Iko kama blue band. You can unaweza spread. It has a spreadable texture. So this is cheese that you can even spread on food. Ukikata kwa kisu, it sticks on the knife because it is too soft. Now, cheese number four, which now does not depend on the hardness or softness, blue veined cheese. Ikona veins, it's a blue. Blue veined cheese, ikona veins. Blue veined cheese. This has an open texture. Let me explain something about it. Now, easy cheese zingine, the hard cheese, the soft cheese, the semi-hard cheese. When we introduce the ripening agent, we introduce it wholly, fully, and we mix. Now, when we come to the blue-veined cheese, and remember we've said that ripening agents are molds, or what we have also called bacteria starters. Ama cultures. So, nimesema they are either we use the rennet enzyme or edible acidic substances like lemon juice and vinegar. With blue veined cheese, we introduce the ripening agents when the cheese is already in its particular container. So, tuna introduce in different parts. For example, kama kwa mkebe, you introduce upper in all, to say me, all the four parts of that container. Apo juu, unamwaga kama lemon juice, this side, that side, and this other side. So, ikiendelea ku ripen, the lemon juice or the vinegar or the rennet enzyme will find its way uko ndani ya cheese, vile inaenda ikiingia uko ndani. So, ikiendelea kuingia uko ndani, inaenda ikiacha kanjia. Nako kanjia huwa kana turn blue. Such that when you look at the cheese, inakaa kama iko na zile veins za damu, but ni za blue. Hiyo ni kukuonyesha, that was the route that the mold or the bacteria was using to get into the cheese. That is why the name originated from the blue vein cheese. So when you look at it, it looks like it has veins, and the veins are blue. So write this about blue vein cheese. It has an open texture, which allows molds to be introduced. It has an open texture, which allows molds to be introduced and grow. Molds to be introduced and grow, as well as spread throughout the cheese. As well as spread throughout the cheese. So that is what we call the blue-veined cheese. Now, those are the types of cheese or the classifications of cheese that I wanted you to know. So once you go back to your handout, you look at the classification or types of cheese. Whichever I have not handled, make sure you write short notes about it. Now, my assignment on cheese. This is your assignment on cheese. Discuss the purchasing and the storage points for cheese. Discuss the purchasing and the storage points for cheese. Discuss the purchasing and the storage points for cheese. So when you are going to purchase cheese, what will you consider? Also, when you are storing cheese, how do you store it? That is my question on cheese. And before I go to butter, write uses of cheese. Uses of cheese. Uses of cheese. Use number one, uses of cheese, use number one, used as a sandwich fillings. What is a sandwich? When you take two slices of bread and you have something in between them, that is a sandwich. So we can have cheese as a sandwich filling. Number two, it is used in pastries, used in pastries. We know pastry products, we know banana flans, we know tartlets and tarts. Those are pastries. Used in pizzas, kila mtu anajua pizza, lazima ikuwe na cheese because cheese is the one which melts there on top, inashikilia all the other toppings. So used in pizzas. Used as a garnish for soups. Inatumika kugarnish soup. Cheese used as a garnish for soups. Another use. It is used to flavor savories. Savories are salty dishes. Salty dishes. So any salty dish. Tukieka cheese, it has a nice taste. Savory dishes, and it is most common with the pasta. Nikisema pasta namaanisha spaghetti, macaroni, the pen, vitu kama hizo. That's why tuko na recipe inaitwa macaroni cheese. So, it's used in flavoring savories. Then it is used in salads. Or I already told you that, used in salads. Now this brings me to the end of cheese. Brings me to the end of cheese. So let me introduce butter. Butter is the shortest milk product. Now remember, we are talking about dairy products. And I said under dairy products, we have eggs. And then we have milk and its products. So we've talked about eggs, we've talked about types of milk, and now we are on the milk products. Our milk product number one was yogurt and fermented milk. Number two was cheese. So all along now we've been talking about number two, which is cheese. So now let's go to milk product number three, butter. Number three, butter. And I want you to know very well that butter is not glue band. Butter is not margarine. Butter is simply butter. The name is butter. And it is made from milk. It is a byproduct of milk. So we write this. I don't know whether you know that mostly butter comes from the milk of cows. What people call mafuta ya ngombe, that is what we call butter. And then there is something else known as ghee. Kuna mafuta inaitwa ghee ya liquid. Now, ghee is clarified butter. Clarified means what? Imekuwa clear. Imechemshwa mpaka ikaproduce liquid oil. Hiyo liquid oil ya butter inaitwa ghee. Mm-hmm. Okay, Tarsia. So now, I want to talk about butter. So write this about butter. Butter is obtained by beating. Beat ni kufanya ni kupiga. Butter is obtained by beating. I don't know whether there are people who have seen people wenye wanatoa mafuta kwa maziwa ya ngombe vile huwa wana beat hiyo maziwa ikiwa kwa kibuyu until wakitoa ndani it has already produced mafuta and then the mafuta is collected out of the milk. That is beating, the beating I'm talking about. It is also known as churning. So it is obtained by beating. Another statement about butter. Clarified butter is known as ghee. Nimesema ku clarify ni kufanya kitu ikuwe clear. So, clarified butter is simply hiyo mafuta umeiweka kwa moto ukaichemsha to an extent that it can never go back to liquid. Inakuwa liquid. Hiyo tunaiita ghee. Clarified butter is known as ghee, which is produced by Sawa Angela. Clarified butter is known as ghee, which is produced by heating. Kuheat, kuweka kwa moto. Produced by heating butter to make it clear. Heating butter to make it clear. That is all about butter, about the definition of butter and ghee. Now, before I move on to my last milk product, which is cream, the last one, there's something I want you to write about. Is it there, about butter? No, you're not writing anything else about butter. When you go to your handout under milk products where there is butter, you're going to look at the uses of butter and you will see them. So allow me to go to my very last part on milk products. So milk product number four, cream. Milk product number four is known as cream. Cream. So write this. Cream is a dairy product. Cream is a dairy product comprising of the higher butter fat. Cream is a dairy product comprising of the higher butter fat layer, skimmed from the top of milk. Kila mtu anajua cream ile ya maziwa. Ukiboil maziwa ukiweka inajiseparate. There is that top part na kuna ile liquid. So ile top part ndio tunaita nini? Cream. So we use that particular top part to process now the final cream. Now, types of cream. Which types of cream do you know? The ones that we see in the kitchen, like double cream, single cream, fresh cream, whipping cream, those are the types we are talking about, not anything else. So, types of cream. Number one is half cream. And the reason why we are giving them these names, we are giving them names according to their fat content. You are going to see that. So half cream. The fat content is 12%. Just write that. Half cream. The fat content is 12%. Another point about it. It can be stored for 3 months unopened. So without opening half cream, unaweza iweka for 3 months, not in the fridge, just on the shelf for 3 good months. The other point, once opened, ukishafungwa, once opened, store in the fridge for 2 to 3 days. Once opened, store in the fridge for 2 to 3 days. The last sentence about half cream. It is suitable for using in sauces and pouring into coffee. Sauces and pouring into coffee. So, unaweza weka kwa coffee. Now, I know you do service, so mwalimu service najua anawafunza mambo ya coffee yenye mnaikaga cream. So pouring into coffee. The second sauce, not sauce, second cream, second type of cream, number two, single cream. Single, tumetoka kwa half, we are now in single. The fat content is 18%. The fat content is 18%. It stays for 2 to 3 days under refrigeration. Hii lazima refrigerate only 2 to 3 days. It stays for 2 to 3 days. Under refrigeration. Point number three, it cannot be frozen. So he wears yaka kwa freezer. You only refrigerate for 2 to 3 days. It is not frozen nor whipped. Again, you cannot whip. Where's whip single cream? So it is not frozen and it is not whipped. The last sentence about it, it is suitable for soups and sauces. Suitable for soups and sauces. Unaweza iweka kwa soup ama kwa sauce. Type of cream number three, soured cream. Cream yenye iko sour, yenye inaonja fermented. Soured cream. It is single cream. Sasa uangalie the similarity. It is simply single cream. But remember tunasema soured. Sour means you may ferment. It is single cream into which single cream into which starter cultures have been added, into which starter cultures have been added. Ukisema starter cultures have been added, tunamaanisha nini? We've added those things which make it ferment. Nimesema renate enzyme, lemon juice, vinegar. So into which starter cultures have been added. The other point about it, fat content is 18%. So just like the single cream, fat content is 18%. It stays for 2 to 3 days under refrigeration. So hizo zote ni similar na single cream. Hazina tofauti. The only difference between sour cream na single cream is that sour cream imesha ferment. So stays for 2 to 3 days under refrigeration. Next point about it. Cannot be whipped or frozen. Cannot be whipped or frozen. Cannot be whipped or frozen. The last point about it. It is suitable as a salad dressing. Suitable as a salad dressing and for savory dishes. It is suitable as a salad dressing and for savory dishes. I have already said that savory dishes are salty dishes and especially pasta dishes. Type of cream number 4, whipping cream. Unajua whipping cream, when you want to whip to decorate cake ama cookies, whipping cream. That is cream number 4. Type of cream number 4, whipping cream. Fat content is 35%. Hiyo iko na mafuta sana. Fat content is 35%. Another statement. It stays for 2 to 3 days under refrigeration. It stays for 2 to 3 days under refrigeration. The other point, it whips up to double. Ukiwhisk, ukiwhip ama ukibeat, it doubles. Kila mtu ameona hivyo tukiwa jikoni. When we beat whipping cream, inakuwa mingi na thickena, inakuwa mingi. So it whips up to double its original volume. Whips up to double its original volume. Another point, it can be frozen for 2 months. It can be frozen for 2 months. It can be frozen for 2 months. So, tumesema it stays for 2 to 3 days under refrigeration, but kama una freeze, then 2 months. You can freeze for 2 months. The last point about it. It is ideal for piping onto cakes and other desserts. It is ideal for piping onto cakes and other desserts. Cream number 5, double cream. This one is another common one that we use in the kitchen almost every practical. Double cream. Write this about it. It is suitable for cooking. Yes, this one is suitable for cooking. It can withstand heat. It is suitable for cooking. For example, when you are making beef stroganoff, huwa tunaitumia sana. It is suitable for cooking. Number 2, it is used in sauces. Used in sauces, comma, soups. Soups. And it floats on coffee. Huwa ina float kwa coffee. It is used in sauces, soups, and floats on coffee. It can be frozen for 2 months. Can be frozen for 2 months. The fat content is 48%. Fat content is 48%. Then I go to my cream number 6. There are only 8, so I'm finishing. Number 6, clotted cream. Again, we see the word clot. Clotted cream in a manisha nini? It's not smooth. For chunks. Clotted cream. Fat content is 55%. Fat content is 55%. The other point, it keeps for 4 to 6 days refrigerated. Keeps for 4 to 6 days refrigerated. Point number 3, may be frozen for 1 month. Frozen for 1 month. Na point ya mwisho, not recommended for cooking. It is not recommended for cooking. Then someone might wonder, if it is not recommended for cooking, what is it used for? It is mostly used for serving on top of scones. Kila mtu anajua scones. So you serve it on top of scones together with the strawberry jam. Hiyo ni swali inaweza kuja kwa service, discuss the service of scones. So unajua kwa service of scones lazima kukue na clotted cream na strawberry jam. Number 7, sterilized half cream. Sterilized, tulisema anything sterilized or anything sterile. It means it is not reactive. So sterilized half cream. Half cream was our cream number 1. So when it is sterilized, it simply means it is that same half cream, but now it has been heated to become sterile. We write, it stays for 2 years unopened. Stays for 2 years unopened, nakaa miaka mbili, because it is sterilized. So if you do not open it, it will stay for 2 years. The other point, stays for 2 to 3 days refrigerated once opened. Stays for 2 to 3 days refrigerated once opened. Fat content is 12%. So fat content haibadiliki, iko tu kama ile ya half cream. Fat content is 12%. On to my last type of cream, number 8, sterilized full cream. Sterilized full cream. Sterilized full cream. Fat content is 23%. Fat content is 23%. Stays for up to 2 years unopened. Stays for up to 2 years unopened. That is it about cream. Now, this is my assignment on cream. So write my assignment on cream. Discuss assignment on cream, number 1. Discuss the storage points of cream. Discuss the storage points of cream. And number 2, discuss the points in using cream. So when you are using cream, what should you consider? Discuss the points in using cream. So those are my 2 questions about cream. And this now brings me to the end of dairy products. This brings me to the end of dairy products. So now I'm opening up the session for you to give me any questions, any concerns or comments that you are having. Let me get them. Maswali sasa zikuje. Maswali. Emma, you've not spoken in this class. Say something. Emma. You've disappeared. Okay. The difference between half sterilized cream and full sterilized cream, their difference is the fat content. Hata ukiangalia percentage. Half ikona 12%, full ikona 23%. So the only difference is the fat content. With the half sterilized cream, ikona 12% fat. The full sterilized cream, ikona 23% fat. That is the only difference. All the other points zinafanana. Like staying for 2 years unopened, staying for 2 to 3 days refrigerated once opened, it does not whip. Hizo zote zinafanana. The only tofauti ni fat content. Any other question? Faith, question? Valerie, question? Evelyn, question? Okay, none. Okay, then. Now, remember, I've told you to also go to the handouts here last week. Yenye tulisoma mambo ya butchery products. I've told you to go and read about poultry and highlight, ama outline, the points to consider, the quality purchasing points of poultry and the storage. We also discussed the storage of poultry. Now, Emma, you've hibernated. I'm waiting for your question. Emma, ninangoja swali lako. Maswali zenu ndizo nangoja. Valerie, do you have a question? Evelyn, do you have a question? Okay, then if you do not have a question there, you do not have questions, then this is going to be the end of our class for today. So when we meet next, Sawa, Evelyn, no question. Faith, no question. When we meet next, we'll be talking about dry groceries. Remember, this term is majorly about our food commodities. So we talked about the herbs, spices, and condiments. Talked about butchery products. Now we've talked about dairy products. So next, we are going on to our dry grocers. And dry grocers will be majorly about the starch. Vitu kama rice, wheat, pasta, vitu kama hizo. That is what we'll talk about in the dry groceries. So I know according to the course outline, you're supposed to talk about vegetables, but I taught vegetables last term. So right now we are dealing with those topics that were not covered in the other term, in the production two course outline. So then that is it. Thank you for joining the live session. Until next week.